Now we will revise laws of reflection. The first law of reflection, the incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence. The point of incidence out here is O. So it should be lies on the same plane. So the incident ray, reflected ray, definitely the corresponding reflected ray. Suppose we get another incident ray out here and we take this reflected ray, then the law will not be obeyed. So the incident ray and the corresponding reflected ray, the normal at the point of incidence, O is the point of incidence, lies on the same plane. This is the first law. Second law tells us that the angle I is equals to angle R. Angle I is equals to angle R. Angle I is the angle of incidence, angle R is the angle of reflection. So if I is 37 degree, R will be also 37 degree. So whatever be the measurement of angle I, angle R will be having the same measurement. Always remember, angle of incidence, which you'll make a mistake, angle of incidence is the angle between the incident ray and the normal, and angle of reflection is the angle between the reflected ray and the normal. Generally what mistake you'll do, you'll take the other angle, which angle of incidence is making with the plane or the surface of separation or the polished surface or the mirror. You'll generally take this angle as angle of incidence, which is wrong, and this angle as angle of reflection, which is wrong. So angle of incidence and angle of reflection is angle with the normal.